home. Are you videoing it?
Not yet. Yeah, I am videoing it. I'm not photo booting it. Anyway, so what's needed on your part to get your book into shape? Because today, when we have 1 month and it should be sent off to the printer, I don't even think that's true. I think we might have less than a month. And I do want to say that next week we're on vacation, so you don't have support. Now, just because the word vacation shows up, I'll tell you, in my universe, I'm not sure how to spell vacation or what one looks like or what they're like, because I can't tell you enough how you guys really should be working on your books while we're not together, okay? And don't underestimate what it takes. So, that being said, so John, I'm trying to figure out what you're doing.
Careful, I'm setting up another.
So are you setting up a camera over there?
Yeah.
Okay, because I was going to set up a camera over here.
Perfect. We'll have three, and then I can pick and choose which is the best.
Everybody else hates that. Okay. All right. So one of the things John said to me last week as I get home, and John says, it's, we've uploaded our videos from the class, and then John says, imagine what all the students in your following classes would have benefited from the critique of all of your menus. And I have to say that you guys are truly all amazing and awesome and accomplished and energetic and enthusiastic and all these beautiful positive adjectives that you all earn, because the work you do in here and the feedback and support you give one another is truly, it's very powerful. And when John sent me that comment, I felt bad. I thought, yeah, he's at 100% right. You have so much to offer other people. And John has always said to you, if you just don't want anything you say captured, we might not stop it in the middle, but John can redact it. What he basically does is he just leaps it all out, you know, like edits the video. But
I'll fuzz off their face.
Yeah, or something like that. I don't know. You tell him what you want, he'll do it. But if you've watched previous videos of other classes, or you've ever read through somebody else's process book for the assignment links, which I've asked permission from students to use, I bet they benefit you, right?
Do they?
Yeah. And they're just not committed. They benefit you guys? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, you know, cut somebody a break, right? Give them some support, and if you're willing to. And we'll continue to capture stuff today. The other part is, I did have students in the past tell me that when we critique, like when you stand up here and talk about your discussion, you discuss your prototype, for example, you don't have to stress out that you're not capturing feedback. You don't have to take notes. You don't have to forget what got said, because it's there for you if you want to, you know, scrub through the little slider bar on the video to grab it. So that being said, I'm going to stop where I am. I'm going to turn this video on. So yes, you're going to be captured. Yes, John.
One other thing, if you want to save your video but you don't want it public, let me know and I can put it on a password protected page that only you can access.
So, okay. And are you planning to like turn on a video for each student? Because I want to know if I should make this part of our flow. What's your plan?
I don't know.
You don't have a plan.
I'm going to take what I have and make what I can.
Right. I'm going to photo booth this, which means, if you're going to talk about your menu, come.
We have two other photo booths running right now.
All right.
So we got to catch
I'll just leave this as recording, and I won't photo booth this thing.
No, do photo booth.
Do booth. Okay. Yeah. So I'm going to photo booth this, and then, so that means I'd be a photo booth, you guys. And no, it doesn't. Remember when we entered full screen, how it cut my window out? So I'm going to escape full screen, which it paused our recording when we were in full screen photo booth at some point, I think.
Okay, well, these are running.
So we'll just leave this small, like this.
These are running. So.
Okay, so who wants to go first? Okay. Okay, Ben, we really want you right here. Yeah, sit sideways if it profiles your good luck. Okay. Okay.
So this is Tiki Taco.
Yeah, show the camera. Yeah, show the camera. Gotta zoom in. All right.
I printed it twice because first one, I didn't really like these lines right here. Uh-huh. The spacing was kind of off right here.
Uh-huh.
You all can see. Second time I printed it.
Will you have me that one too?
Second time I printed it, it flipped upside down.
Oh, when you printed it back and back?
Yeah.
Back to back?
So that's what happened there. And they're fast street style tacos on the beach. Tiki taco.
Okay. So tell us about your logo. Show your logo on the screen. You did a nice job on this logo. So is that a glyph?
No, that's like Illustrator. Just drew it.
So if you will change anything now that you've redone it, do you have anything you want to change?
Not really. I mean, I've been looking at it for so long, I could probably use some help for that.
Okay. Okay. Can I see your little guy? And I'll let you go past that one around. All right. So you didn't change your spacing on this one.
No, I didn't.
Your bullets?
No, like go making it go up. Like, it's not even spacing.
Oh, letting. The word is letting.
Letting.
Okay. I'm right, aren't I? The word's letting?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. All right. So, now I see you changed. You changed a lot on this. Mm-hmm. You improved all kinds of things.
Like the hierarchy.
Wait, say that louder for the video.
I like the hierarchy.
Yeah, you did a really good job. So let's kind of show and compare. So one of the things that give Ben feedback. I don't want to talk yet. So I'm going to pass this around, you guys. So if you're looking at it, you want to give Ben some.
Your menu to be like the bigger size or the smaller size?
The bigger size.
I think
sure.
The bigger size is really cool.
Second time I printed it, I couldn't get cardstock either. So.
You printed here?
Yeah.
All right, so if you look at, anybody else got comments for it? So if you look at Ben's menu, actually, Leah, we hand it to Ben. He's going to hold it in front of the camera. And I could show it, so open it up, please. Okay. So one of the things he did in his revision was, and all of you, if you're looking at, like Zion's looking at it now, one of the things you did is you corrected all of your letting, and you corrected all your space before or space after your subheads. So what you did that you did not do on the one that's in front of the camera right now is what's in front of the camera does not have continuity. In other words, he has a headline, and his type's real close, and then his next headline's real close, and then his type's real close, and his next headline's real close, and then he's got a big oops gap where something's gappy, his letting, his line spacing is gappy. So on the one that Zion's looking at, he's from my memory, from scanning it, you're pretty consistent. You're consistent on your right panel, and you're consistent on your left panel. And that's the key. That's the kind of thing we're going to talk about constantly. You know, when you're in doubt, consistency is everything. Your center panel, let me take a look at that right there. Your center panel on this one is consistent. The only thing that's not consistent, well, yeah, but he fixed it on that one. That one's fixed. Is your word hard tacos? Isn't in uppercase, but everything else is in uppercase.
Even on that one?
I don't know. ask Olivia.
Hard
tacos right up here.
Yeah, the
upper lowercase or
it's lowercase, but all of these. I think this is maybe meant to be a continuation of Atlas, and then
but nothing else is bold and upper and lowercase. On the whole thing, on the whole menu, nothing else is in bold without being all uppercase.
These are lowercase.
Oh, those are.
So I think, yeah, I think you meant to be a continuation.
So you meant to be continued. Okay. And what you might want to do for the continuation, you know, white reverse type would also fly because this is such a deep gold. Mm-hmm. That would be okay too.
Okay.
But Olivia's right. She's got your back.
Yeah, that's why I like underlined this part. To make it like another.
Oh, another category kind of like this, you mean?
Yes.
Like that. Yeah, I got it. I'd like to say, I'm glad you got rid of the dotted line. I don't think it helped you. I'd like to say that no illustrations in this. You already know that. So these are out the door. No illustrations, no images. The logo was the only thing we kind of had we were ambiguous about. And I'd like for you to handle this with more continuity of spacing, like, you know, get rid of that, maybe move Tiki Taco logo to the top, and then unify this more. It all feels just kind of like you spread it out and didn't know how to fill up your page, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Was that the case?
Yeah,
kind of. Right. And then here, you know, you have the option to say about us. You could have written a whole essay here, you know, or you could have made it smaller. Generally speaking, keep in mind this for your books, generally speaking, center text is hard to read. I mean, it's not a lot of type here, so it's not hard. It's big type you did. But you might have thought more about that. And you probably would want to make the U and us uppercase, which is called the title case. Okay? And, you know, there's all kinds of different things to do. You could tell a story. You could have, you know, you're missing the address if somebody took this as a to-go item. Mm-hmm. You could tell a story. You could make up some story about why it's called Tiki Taco. Instead of just saying about us, you know, it's called Tiki Taco because... And just have a good time, like have fun. That's the good part about this. So, for example, if you chose to use this as a portfolio piece, those are the things I would change to enhance it more. You did a really good job on the scale of it. You did a good job on your three panels. You did a good job with your roll fold. All of that works. So, okay. So, good work. Oh, have it share. So, who's next? Okay, Shoji, come on up. Oh, it's not yours? You already went. All right, who's next? Olivia's next. Am I in the way?
I don't know the thing.
Went to sleep.
Went to sleep.
Look at the camera, say hi. Show him your menu.
This is Liv's Diner. The concept I wanted to have was kind of like a comfort, a classic diner feel with comfort food. But I always think about when I eat comfort food, it's normally like fast food or like diner restaurants. I think a lot about where the food comes from, and there's a lot of guilt involved with like the meat you're eating or the dairy you're eating. So I wanted to make a restaurant that was the slogan is comfort food, guilt free. So there's like organic, free range, fair trade, cage free eggs, cruelty free, natural foods. A lot of like I have milkshakes, but they're you have almond soy or coconut milk ice cream with them instead of dairy. So just kind of a fun play on the comfort foods that we all like, mac and cheese and burgers and things. Yeah, that's kind of the concept. So I wanted to do like the checker kind of, I wanted to portray like a classic 50s diner. I hand did the logo.
Is this the scale of yours?
It's not. It was supposed to be bigger, but I couldn't. I went somewhere to get it printed, and I tried here, and that was as big as I could get it. It was supposed to be, like, each square is supposed to be 5 by 5. So I set up the...
Best thing to do would be to tile it.
Okay.
Like, tile your poster mm-hmm. and just assemble it.
Yeah,
way,
it was supposed to be much bigger, but I wasn't sure if you wanted that or if I should have just kept it small. It's a little hard to read. Yeah, it was 20 by 5, and it was meant to
right.
be a little bigger.
Do you know the name of the fold you made?
Accordion fold.
Which is just
an accordion fold.
Yeah, I was just gonna play with it
yeah.
like that for you. Just so
I didn't
you
know if there was a more technical name for it.
No, it's exactly 100% the name for it. So. Oh, you didn't think about the back, did
no,
you?
No, I didn't, and that's one thing that I've been was You're thinking about. I was thinking about connecting this so it was more just like a normal, but I wasn't sure if I wanted to do that. So, yeah, I'm not happy with the open space back there, but I thought I could maybe glue that together and just have like a little booklet like that. There's a lot I probably would have changed on it, I couldn't get the checkered board to align
uh-huh.
properly on one side.
On the fold?
It was,
yeah,
on that side, so that was a little frustrating.
What about the dash lines? Did you want those to print? Is that intentional?
I don't, I didn't think that they would show up as much as they did, but after seeing it, I didn't really mind it. I kind of liked them more, so I just left them. But yeah, I should have utilized the backspace more to put, I forgot to do the phone number and address and everything. So I could have put that there. But
right, and in about. Or
yeah.
yeah. Okay, I'm going to talk about Junko Wang. You get to show and tell on. Does anybody have comments on it? Can you see?
I love your logo. It's so cool.
You really
I love the heart. It's really small. It's like the V's
are all
heart, right? Yeah. Yeah, it's very clever. And the colors are awesome.
More comments?
I can totally see the designer.
You can totally see the designer.
Mm-hmm.
Still go around, but I just figured for you guys to comment. And it's hard to read because it's small.
I like what, your headers though. Like,
her headers.
Just like the subtle outline. I like your typeface pairings.
Sure about the outlining on the header. I know we're not really supposed to do that, but I'm
really glad you brought that up.
I had it white, like this
mm-hmm.
sentence,
mm-hmm.
but it was just really hard to read, and then I had it black, and it just was too dark, so I kind of thought it matched the outline on the logo.
Mm-hmm.
If I were to outline it, so I'm sure how you feel about that.
Yeah, I'm not the final one.
Okay, so let's talk about the logo. Oh, Gary, did I miss you? I'm sorry. Can you see?
Yeah.
Okay. So Olivia's comment was, how do you feel about outline type for libs, the word libs, for the diner? And I think your choice is fantastic, personally, because she has a deeper pink color inside filling your type, and your type is bold and very simple. And then you have these wings that are white, so they kind of take flight, which is a really fun balance. And makes you actually really, in my opinion, achieved a really excellent balance with the scale of your letters, the scale of the wings,
and the balance of the deeper pink against the lighter pink background and the white. And you couldn't pull that off without that huge stroke. Right. And if it was white, it would feel different. It would feel kind of, I think, a little empty. It probably did.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody complimented you on your use of your headline type or your subhead type.
That was me. And also, wasn't the question, the stroke question, about the headline type?
Yeah. It was,
oh, the headline type. Oh, yeah. Thank you. I didn't hear it right. No, it still works. And actually, one of the things I'd probably tell you to do is stroke that
mm-hmm.
for continuity because it's inconsistent. And it doesn't stand out as well as the stroke on the other.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact that you stayed with a limited pink and black color palette really works well, I think, actually. I wanted to come in front of the camera for this reason. You wanted to glue this, so basically you had the one page that was back-to-back because you didn't fill in the back.
Mm-hmm.
The economics of that, when you print something, don't make sense.
Mm-hmm.
Your accordion fold and not printing anything on the back, which is just a waste of real estate, is still cheaper than paying somebody to glue
mm-hmm.
that page. If you're making a single item prototype for something, that's great, but there's no way really to accomplish this and bind it except for gluing it. So you'd probably instead make it an 8-page booklet instead
mm-hmm.
of, what is that, 6 pages. Because a 6-page booklet would be like Tiki Taco. You just fold it like that as a
right.
fold. Or you'd accordion fold it the other way. So if Ben, does
right.
that, folds it back, then you'd accordion fold it that way.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a 6-page accordion fold.
Okay.
So,
I like the accordion.
I'm sorry, go. Yeah, I really like how you designed it. How did you like create the wings and the cursive and the heart for the feet?
Everything I just did by hand, and then I actually just took a photo of it and put it on Illustrator, and then
traced it.
Yeah, traced it, and then.
Are you new to Illustrator?
No, I have the most experience
with Illustrator.
That's
cool.
My house is red. And then then I just added color to all the shapes. And, I did have it thinner with a thinner outline.
Uh huh.
And then I
beefed up a little.
Hand drew it.
You have a nice hierarchy of type in there. When it's full size, I'm sure it'd be more readable. I can't tell yet if your leading for your description is too tight or not
mm-hmm.
because it's so small scale, but I think your hierarchy is great. It's clean. And just probably taking those two pages and making them work for you
mm-hmm.
somehow would be my
advice.
Anything else? Anybody?
Do anything different?
What do you mean?
I don't know. What do you like about it? What do you want to improve on it?
When I first printed it, I realized that my subheads, I put them in small caps, and I have each letter uppercase, so that uppercase letter was super bold.
Mm-hmm.
So I changed it all to lowercase and then added small caps, so that it was more.
For your subheads? They're all lowercase and they're small caps, so
right.
they're all small.
So they're all the same, yeah.
Got it. And to us, we don't know that they're small caps. We just know that they're all caps.
Yeah.
Okay. Got it. Yeah, bindery like this is challenging, but what a nice job you did doing it.
Instead of paper,
thanks.
Make it look like a book.
Yeah.
Oh, should I send it? Should I send it that way? More thoughts? How did you make the logo?
In Illustrator. I just drew it. And then...
So I have a question for you. On one of your headlines, you have a price. $3 on one of your headlines. What is it?
Where?
Up front? First page? Oh, sides are $4.
Oh, that one.
Next one. And
oh,
something's
yeah,
$3.
It's just continuous
kids.
Throughout. All of the, like,
oh, everything
all
in
the
that
column. All
column.
The same.
All the way down through desserts? No.
No. Just
desserts have prices?
Oh.
No.
See, I thought I added it right there. Those are all the same thing.
Okay. So I probably wouldn't put the price in a headline.
Okay.
It's confusing because it's not consistent, but it's not the thing you want to put in a headline.
Okay.
But on the other hand, that's a pretty good selling point, $3 anything. Right?
Or you could put all, like what if she said like all, like for like $4 or like
yeah.
Below it.
I put it below it in real small type. Everything, all, you know, all
okay.
$3
yeah.
or something. Putting it in the same as a headline diminishes the category header
yeah.
feeling, I think.
Yeah, I was trying to figure out how I should do that.
It looks really organized. You have a header that says sandwiches and more?
Sandwiches and more.
Okay, and there's no space beside the ampersand. I don't think that was intentional. Because when you use the ampersand for other categories, the ampersand is the AM sign. On other places where you use the ampersand, you have space on each side of it.
I think I don't know if I should do that.
Yeah, treat it like a word. Treat the symbol like a word. Any more comments for people who are actually looking at it? Because we can't see it from where we are.
I think it's super well organized, and I really like how you have your pages laid out. I think it's actually very easy to find what you're looking for, and actually everything looks yummy too.
From my memory, your style of all the text. Did you use paragraph style sheets? Did you love paragraph style?
Yeah. I couldn't figure it out at first, like the difference between the character and the paragraph.
Uh-huh.
So it wasn't working at first, but
uh-huh.
then I figured it out.
And then you figured it out.
It was really helpful.
Paragraph style sheets and character style sheets are magic. So if you don't understand them today, be sure you understand them for your book. Because you will not want to create your book without using master pages and character styles. Who in this class doesn't understand what I just said about, and please be honest, master pages and character styles?
I kind of
forgot
how to do master pages. Okay. That was like from the very first.
Very first.
Yeah.
So raise your hand if you would love me to review paragraph styles again. Okay. Raise your hand if. Raise your hand if you want me to review master pages again. Okay. It's going to save your life, you guys. They will save your life. Because you don't want to create a book without it. Yeah, John?
We have a bunch of videos on that, and I'll put them up on the archive links to
yeah.
hours of videos on that.
Yeah.
Hours.
Yeah. Oh, can you move the mouse? Our video just went off. It's rather...
I think it's still...
Yeah, the green light's still...
It still records.
It still records?
Yeah.
Yeah, John's right. We do have hours, but I'll try and do a real quickie just to refresh your memory. So at least you can ask questions while we're sitting together. But I do think I can see your continuity. You also did a really nice job on the first page. Olivia, can you hold it up? On the first page, you have a small paragraph of type about the restaurant, I think. What it is, and maybe information about it. And you weren't afraid, and hold that up, and actually hold that up in front of the camera first, please. Because you weren't afraid to have really big margins. But here's something that's really important for everybody to think about. in the case of the menu, okay, now show everybody, like do a show and tell thing. In the case of the menu, look what happens when you have bindery and the bindery takes a bite from the center of your page, right? So even though her first page was totally centered, because she's got a good inch used up from her bindery, it makes her first page not look centered, kind of visually, even though it is. So what you have to think about is it's your page gutter. It's your page, inside page margins. If you have a book where you're going to have a lot of pages, remember books that are really big kind of inhale the center where the, you know, the pages join? Okay, so you're going to want to accommodate that. So you might have bigger margins in the center where the fold is than on the outside of your pages sometimes. So you're going to have to just try it and see what you think about it. Any other thoughts about the menu? Yeah, nice job with the hierarchy. I do notice that menu. Who's next? Who else do we have?
Sort of a takeout style menu. The restaurant I made up, it kind of copies the public market downtown, that place where like they have a whole bunch of restaurants, but it's in one major building. So that's the kind of restaurant idea I thought of. So in my case, we have six restaurants, or five restaurants and one coffee shop. So on the inner, so first page, second page is the coffee shop. Here. Then we have the rest of the restaurant. And on the back we have.
Yeah, go ahead. And on the back.
On the back is the history and then the contact information.
And if you were to change anything about it?
I honestly, there's a bunch of things that I would tweak, such as the paper I used. I really wanted to use like cardstock. And I guess my fear of like ruining it was mm-hmm. preventing me from trying it. Mm-hmm. So I'm kicking myself for that. Mm-hmm. And I noticed one spelling error, mm-hmm. and that really just kind of like because it's like the dumbest word. It was the word cheese.
Yeah.
I misspelled cheese.
Yeah. And there is spell check in InDesign.
Sorry?
There is spell check.
There is?
In InDesign. Yes, I will show you today.
Thank you. Yes. So the format I chose, the trifold, I thought would in a way separate where I would like it to, such as separating the coffee shop from the restaurants because they had different hours, and having in a sense when you open it up you group all the restaurants together so you can kind of see what you want. You can see everything and then be like, that sounds good, I'm going to go there.
Okay. One of the things, well, let's get comments from people actually. So I know you guys can't see it very easily at a distance.
I like how you have the different types of food or restaurants grouped together. It's really easy to map out and if you feel like something you can find it really quickly and really easily. With breakfast and coffee kind of in the same not the same page but the same fold. So you can flip it over if you're looking at breakfast and look at the coffee. That's good.
I like your headings. They have like different colored rectangles. angles, but you're very consistent with your colors. And I think it's cool. It makes it very readable. And you can tell where the headings are.
So there's a couple things I want to call attention to. Actually, the comments you got from Caitlin and from Olivia are spot on. And Caitlin, right? Okay. I'm in my Kylie, Caitlin. Sorry, you guys. Okay, so I agree with both of you, your comments. One of the things I want to comment on about headlines are, it's true that the color callouts, you know, the little rectangle for the headlines make it really easy. Like, we know exactly where to go. But one of the things that you've done is when you had longer line lengths for a headline, you made the type smaller. Do not do that. Find your longest line length when you have a headline and size it for that. See if it looks good and stick to it. That's why you have paragraph style sheets. So if it's a 12-point headline or 14-point, then everything is going to be even if it doesn't fill the box. Okay? So that's continuity. Same thing in the back for history. All your headlines are upper and lower case, but history is only all uppercase. Continuity. You have a style sheet, you don't have any of you style sheets, you don't have the opportunity to say, oops. Style sheet just keeps you consistent. That's why you guys want style sheets. There's a million reasons why you want style sheets. That's one of the million reasons. The other thing is, you're not alone, Miss Leah. I find that most students don't know what to do with white space and they freak out. Like, oh my God, I can't have space on a page. So what am I going to fill it with? And in your case, we're sitting inside your restaurant ordering food, and the largest thing in your menu is the hours you're open. So I get to sit there while I'm already inside eating, and the largest thing you're enticing me with is the hours you're open. Here's where you should sell me your triple fudge sundae in your restaurant. Or your lobster roll because it's $25 and everything else is $3. That's like primo real estate. So when it comes to a menu, you want to use your primo real estate and say, how can I upsell these people? That's what restaurant people do, right? I mean, when they create those little boxes or they put the star next to it, that's the house favorite, or you know, or they have you add things or whatever. So keep in mind, white space is not bad. White space is not bad. It's a good opportunity to use it to promote something. And then the other thing is, on your front, you wrote industrial market, and then you, in a really interesting way, took the word industrial market and made kind of a logo type out of it, which you really didn't highlight enough because it's super cool. It's, you know, it's a public market, it's industrial, we're into buildings and structures with public market, and so I would just leave this lovely, abstract, really heavy industrial market logo you made and just nix this type out of here. Because you're basically saying industrial market.
Yeah.
And that doesn't make sense.
The one concern, I thought about that, and the concern I had about that was, how will people
They're in it. You can read that, even though it's really kind of funky, I think. Can you guys read it? Yeah. And you might want to put a little teeny tagline below that says, everything in industrial market is made fresh and gathered from local blah, 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 blah. And then you've given me the cue. You move the mask. Then you've given me the cue. But then you give it the cue, basically, of what this is supposed to read as. Yeah. So don't forget to read your. I'm going to which way should I pass this way? You read your website, right? Right? Did
no.
I'm going this way?
Yeah, I did.
Did I grab that? I lost track about what I was starting to say. So So remember, use your style sheets. Oh, I know what I was going to say. Read your own work. Read your own work fresh or hand it to somebody and say, what does that say? Point to all the elements on the page. What does that say? What does that communicate to you? How does it make you feel? Because we can't see our own stuff sometimes. Yeah. But nice organization, Todd.
Unique about this restaurant is that everything is self-involved. I tried this twice, but I couldn't get the colors right. This is supposed to be a blueberry purple, but a little muted tone because I thought the logo is bright enough, so I wanted something to balance it.
Where'd you print it?
This? I know it looks like a booklet, but if you look in, there are only two or three items in each of those, so it's easy to remember what is there, so it's not very crowded. Oh yeah, one more thing. I stapled it, but I didn't want to staple it. I wanted to sew it with twine.
Uh-huh.
I just couldn't find the right twine. So
is that cardstock?
Yeah. The reds, what looks like red, it's not red, it's pink. But it came out red, and the blue is deeper. So the colors are really
the blue is what?
It's deeper. It's not that red.
Did you use master pages?
Yes. I use master
pages. On everything.
On
everything.
Mm.
That's so interesting.
I think the branch bowls, it doesn't look.
Master page?
Yeah, because it has two sublines.
Oh, it moved
add-ons.
It.
Yeah, so
did you center things in your boxes or something? No, it just bounced it up.
Yeah, it bounced it up.
Okay, so this is what, when we pass this around, this is what I want to talk about. Oh, well, actually, give your opinions first. I'm sorry, I always start talking. And I think it's hard to see at a distance, isn't it? A little hard. All right, then I'm going to talk for you. Keep moving the mouse, so. This is what I'd like for all of you to look at. Did you hand letter your cover?
I did, but I found a font which is very close to it.
So better.
So I just stroke the thing because it's really the best as well.
Okay. Does anybody in their life ever eat Cracker Jacks?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Do you know what Cracker Jacks are? It's a box. The reason why I bring it up is in little toy things like that, they'll have these little books, little flip books where you fan them and things move because it's the same image and it shifts a little. When you use a master page, which is why I asked Anuja if she used master pages, if I flip through this book like that, can you see the headlines except for on one page are exactly in the same place? Headlines should be all in one place, except for one page. You see that? Okay. A master page, the benefit of a master page is that you have continuity. Everything's predictably in one place. So her headlines don't bounce around from page to page. They're always even. So when you flip the page of a book or you fan the page of a book, you have continuity of design. Same thing with setting up tabs and so forth with pricing. If you flip the pages, the pricing, the blue column of type is always in the same position. Those are the advantages of master pages and designing with continuity. All right. The other thing I want to call attention to in here that Anuja did is, so here's her cover, it's compelling. Her colors didn't pop the way I think she expected them to, because if that was deeper, the gold or orange would go zing, right?
And the blue highlight that I have.
And the blue highlight would pop even more. The other thing she does is she's like, she's unapologetic for nothing on these pages except for color. So for those of you who think every page has to be filled with type or a thing or something, look how fun it is just to open the page and just see pretty color, right? Like immediately, I'm in a good mood. This is a happy place. And then you move to this page and notice again, and it is a booklet that you created. Again, her menu, her book started with a right-hand page. So when you make books, start with a right-hand page. She could put a little icon here. She could put a little bold lip, because it was type only, right here. She wanted a sense of humor. Something. But there's no reason not to have breathable, empty space. Don't underestimate the value of letting somebody's eyes rest or the personality that just a solid will offer. And then when you flip through this, you'll notice again continuity by using, and I'm pretty sure you probably did paragraph style sheets because Anuja's done this a while, paragraph style sheets, and it makes your life easier just by knowing that you have continuity of design. So I'm going to pass this way, but maybe you guys saw some things as I split the room with the comments for.
I love your color palette. It's really beautiful, and I agree that the pages that are just blank, full of color, are really nice. It is kind of like a vacation for the text. The one, I also really like your the typeface that you chose, with the two typefaces for the logo.
Really good suggestion. More thoughts?
Well, I haven't seen it up close, but the pages of color make it seem really like professionally, they're like design forward or design conscious, and it looks like, you know, somebody paid a lot of money to have that menu designed. So
well, when they hire her, they will.
I think it looks really great.
Thank you.
More thoughts? Okay, I'm going to let that keep passing around. Nice work. Okay, did we miss anybody? Is that everybody? No. Come on, Scott. Come on up. We take a quick glimpse. Have a seat in the big chair and move the mouse for a second.
I kind of envision it looks like a bar casino type of place. I kind of envision it like a Rusty's, but like a little bit nicer, and like you can actually get like a better buzz. But it's really just like a chill place to go. Maybe with kids, like let them like play some video games or something.
Anything you'd do differently now that you see it done?
More white space.
More white space?
Yeah. Uh-huh. It was actually supposed to be on an 8.5 by 11, but I was kind of in there training for a while, so I didn't want to hassle the trainers anymore. But
Well, you had a bleed, and you trimmed it down to your bleed.
Yeah.
So it probably could be 8.5 by 11 and bleed. Is probably. Do you understand that?
Yeah, yeah, I understand.
But
even, like, it was even bigger, like even.
Oh, even with a bleed, it could have been bigger. So who's got comments for Scott? Did you make adjustments? What adjustments did you make based on the critique?
Try to just like fix a lot of things. A lot of things were just the colors were wrong. I used the registration black and a lot of stuff, but it's kind of weird. And not just that, I just tried to make everything more the same. And I probably could have even done a little bit more of that. I tried to do something, I tried to mirror like this.
Mm-hmm. Show everybody who said you're checking out. And what is it you like about that side more?
Just that it's more the same, and I kind of like how this is different. Just adds like more emphasis to it.
What adds more emphasis? I'm sorry, say that again.
Just like this stuff, like the one scoop, two scoop, just the ice cream.
You have some type that got trimmed off. What happened with that on the far right?
There's a little bit of room left, but it almost got tight. Mm-hmm. It actually just iced it. I think that might have just been me trying to cut it.
Cut it clean?
Yeah.
More comments for Scott? What about people trying to stop? They can't see you.
What's the color palette you used? Captures the feeling.
In the areas where your type is really close to the edge, everybody has to understand this is for your book, this is for anything you design. When you create a design where you put type close to the trim, you got to kind of make a commitment. In other words, don't ever put it on the exactly on the trim and think that it's ever going to be trimmed properly. Because if you did a whole bunch of, you know, if you mass produce something and you stack a ton of papers and a knife goes through them, has anybody ever cut a bunch of papers and they start to slide a little? Okay. So even in professional situations, there's a hair of that possibility of it sliding and not cutting clean. So when you want something on the edge, like on the trim, like you feel like the letter's going to kind of bleed, make a commitment, make it bleed. So even design so you know the letter's going to get cut off the page, okay? And then if you don't want it so close to the trim, then you really have to give yourself at minimum an 1/8 of an inch clearance. What you really want is a big comfy margin, okay? So just keep that as a rule of thumb for everybody. The other thing is if you open your book and show everybody your red, your black on red, generally speaking, you've created kind of a hangout place just like you described. On the reds to make it more readable, right? You get this thing fighting with reds and blacks. It's just those two colors, electric blue, like royal blue, black, that's impossible to read. So always print stuff like Scott did to make sure it's readable. If it was a dark environment without lights, it would not be readable. Like if you were in a restaurant that had real low lighting, the black and red, even at your opacity, Scott, wouldn't be readable. So, check those things out. The other thing about menus is, and for anything, you know, you have to think about who your market is. You know, Scott's catering to a young market, people with generally good eyesight. If you're catering to people, it's so funny, I go to restaurants now and I watch all these people pull out their iPhones and turn on their flashlights to read their menu. Do you guys see this ever? No? You guys don't. You don't hang in those circles, right? What's that? You worked one of those places? You see it all the time, right? So people have to, and then you feel stupid. If you're the diner, you feel like embarrassed because there you are, you're the old person with the flashlight on your menu because you can't read it. So always think about who your audience is and who you're designing for and what the mood is you want. All those things should influence your designs, basically. But you created fun, so I'm going to let you pass that around. Any more comments for Scott? Okay. Then roll yourselves back to your seat and we'll shift to a real quickie on a real quickie demo on master pages.
Sorry.
We'll do a quickie demo on master pages, paragraph style sheets, character styles, and you want me to stop right now?
Oh. Oh. Just going to guess and
that. Uh-huh. I photo booth screencast-matic.
I just photo booth.
Okay. All right. We're going to have all kinds of things.
Well, yeah, that'll be interesting.
Do you want me to stop right now and start fresh?
Would you please? Yeah.
Do you guys in the class find benefit from the videos?
Yes.
Does anybody ever go back to old videos, like in previous classes?
Yeah.
Yeah, you have? Not previous hour classes, but like that's classes true. You never attended?
I don't look at old class videos, but I do really like looking at previous class design videos.
Oh, okay, good.
I have for your graphic design basics looked at old class videos.
Have you found them? You worked through the index and stuff?
That's usually I find them if they're provided on the lesson page on your website and you link to them.
Yeah.
But I do find those very helpful.
That's good. Good. For that class you're in, I have to finish making a video. I'm kind of dreading it because it's complicated. I got to figure that one out, and it's only online. Okay, let me pull stuff up. Is everybody all settled in? I was waiting for our screen to pull up. All right. You know what I'm going to do? Let's do our screen. She gives us permission.